A group called Climate Nexus recently brought together some of the top scientists that study the Arctic Ocean. And they did a call to alarm us as to what is going on there. In fact, it appears our Arctic ice seems to be disappearing. Now, they showed pictures of what the Arctic ice looked like back in 1979, and it was significant, as you see there. Now, they show the pictures of what it is today. Not nearly as significant, as you see. Now, I don't know if you can quite see it there, but there's also a tiny line there, and that is actually the average of what the ice receded to, and of course every summer the ice recedes to some degree, but what the ice would recede to over the last three decades. But now the ice melting has sped up, so it now is this, which is much less than the average even of recent years. In fact, let me give you numbers on that. 45% reduction there has been in the ice compared to the 1980s and 1990s. So we've lost 45% of the Arctic sea ice. And as you look at that, that's the Arctic sea ice volume through 2012. And as you can see, it's dropping, 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 and then it is now precipitously dropping as we get closer and closer to current day. Oceans are 30% more acidic now. That's another sign of possible disaster. And the atmosphere is 5% wetter in the oceans. Now, how could the ocean be more wet? Well, if the ice melts into it, that used to be on land. And if the ocean is wetter, and then you've got more and more severe climate that you're going to have. Now, in fact, a scientist warning in this particular case, look, the more the ice melts, the more you have black ocean rather than white ice. It absorbs more heat. And the more heat that it absorbs, the warmer the oceans get, well, that creates another cycle, which means that the storms in the winter this year are much more likely to be extreme. And by the way, the warmer the water is, the more ice melts. So it's a vicious cycle all around. And let me give you more scary details. Peter Wadhams from the University of Cambridge in the UK says that the ice melting is actually having the equivalent of 20 years of carbon dioxide emissions. So this vicious cycle is speeding up and speeding up, and because the bottom line is, if we get to a hotter temperature worldwide, we're in a world of trouble. And you know, some people say, it's not man-made, all the scientists are wrong. But can I add a wrinkle to that I haven't heard anywhere else, which is, so what? Like, let's say the scientists are wrong and it's not man-made. Everybody agrees they're not wrong that it's actually happening. It is getting warmer. The Arctic ice, as you can see with your own eyes, is melting. It is creating these extra situations. We have to stop it either way. If we don't, the weather is going to continue to get much worse. I mean, look, any single weather event is not indicative of anything. But when you have climate change and it leads to clear differences in overall temperatures we've seen in the United States here, we broke a record for the last 12 months before July. It was the hottest 12 months recorded in American history. And then July was the hottest month ever recorded in U.S. history. They started recording back in 1895, and no month has ever been hotter than July. And as you can see, the storms are picking up intensity and the quantity as we go along. And they're saying next year it's going to be even worse because we're losing the Arctic ice as well. We got to get ahead of this. Now, one more amazing fact. The size of the melt this year was the size of Canada and Alaska combined. Every year we get some ice melting in the Arctic Ocean, of course, in the summer. That's how it works. And then in the winter, it freezes up again. But understand that every year lately, we have been losing more and more ice that has led to worse and worse results. And the folks over at Fox News and Shell and ExxonMobil, et cetera, want you to turn away, and they don't want you to do anything about this. But as we suffer the consequences of this, as we did this year, and unfortunately it appears we will next year, and a year after that, we've got to realize at some point, it's time for action. We've got to figure out a way to try to stop this before it's too late. And I don't know what it means if it's too late. Some scientists say, hey, you know what? At most, we've got 16 years left before we hit 2 degrees Celsius. And even in the Copenhagen Accord, which was incredibly weak, all the countries agreed, well, obviously, if we hit an extra 2 degrees Celsius, we're all screwed. Tick tock, tick tock. 16 years is not a long time, and so far, all the scientists' projections have come earlier than they suspected. One projection has the Arctic ice melting entirely within 10 years. Tick tock, tick tock.